So I wish I could have made a video of this, guys, as it was happening, and I might have a second chance at that. But the other day I'm at work and I get a text message from Mama. I forget exactly what it says. You know what, let me pull it up out of my pocket. And by the way, welcome back to the Abundant Harvest Homestead. I'm Papa Pepper. Mama Pepper's here, red pepper, sweet pepper. Oh, we got chili pepper here. That's three of our seven children. But Mama sent me a text message, and her text message said, "Our bees swarmed, help, on your fruit tree in the duck pen." And that fruit tree is actually this one right here. It's a peach tree. It's growing from seed. It was in an old orchard that somebody was brush hogging. And when the old fruit would fall to the ground, they would sprout up. And then somebody was gonna brush hog it down. I said, hold on a second, let me get that tree. If nothing else, it'll be a good rootstock. So, come here, red pepper. What happened that day?
We caught the swarm.
Well, can you tell a little bit of a story before you jump to the punchline and the conclusion of the whole matter? You saw it, right?
Yeah, I saw it, and it looked like a pile of flies because we had just put some carcasses in the chicken pen.
Yeah, so with bow fishing, sometimes we'll give the carcasses of the animals to the suckers, the carp, the whatever, to the chickens, and they'll peck them clean while they're there. There's sometimes flies. She thought it was flies, and then you realized
it was bees.
So, you know, while Mama's working on this, I'm trying to get a hold of them. They got some bee suits on. They're up on these ladders here. It's on that branch. The branch is drooping over, and somehow Mama tells me by the time I get a hold of her, like, oh yeah, she got all the gear. She knew there was a, you were using the smoker.
Yeah.
Okay, when bees swarm, they're the most chill ever. And I'm speaking of just the regular honeybees. I'm not talking about Africanized or other things. But because they have no hive to defend, they're actually pretty relaxed and pretty chill. She did use a smoker because we just got one. And Red Pepper here knew that I had a nuke. I didn't even know I had it. I think it might have came from Tony the Redneck Prepper, but I'll show you what happened over here. They were able to do it and get it all done in my absence, and I'm like, how in the world does our 9-year-old know all this stuff? Like, I don't necessarily know all this stuff. So here's our hive. Okay, there's some things I'm watching right now with these ones around here for a reason I'll show you in a second, but we had two hives last year. That one didn't make it through the winter. This one did. And it was pretty healthy. Over there under that tin is the nuke, and it's got a good pile of bees in as well. And then today, so they caught it and they got set up over there. It's a cardboard box, but it's got the frames in there. I'm just letting them get established on there, and we'll move them into an actual hive, which is exciting. But then just now, where are you? This one comes running to me, and what do you say?
That we found a swarm of bees.
Show me where this is. Can you show me? So I'm sitting there doing some dishes, thinking about my day, thinking about the carp spawn, some big fish, fins and scales. We like to eat them. About to start bow fishing that. And she says she found a swarm. Where is that?
Right over there.
So if you guys want to see, here's what a swarm pretty much looks like. Last one was on a fruit tree branch. This one here is in these bushes. A lot of bees flying around. And there you go. Look at that, guys. So right now, what do you think I am, 5 feet from it? Yeah, probably about 5 feet from it in flip-flops and shorts. And there's a lot of bees around here because this is the part of the hive that's splitting off. There's one on my shorts. Oh yeah, see? Hey buddy, come on off. And I don't want to anger him. So it's all kind of a big bubbling mass around here. Now that we've kind of relaxed and let them gather a little more, there was more on the outside of that hive, and there was more flying around here, but now they're kind of gathering. And one thing is you can kill all the queen cells and just kind of keep your hive going with what it or has originally, but we wanted to build up our availability, right? We wanted more than just a hive. We used to have three. We had a nuke and then we had these two. So if we catch both these swarms, then we're back to where we started. And when I picked up the second two, those were $150 each. It's $300 worth of bees just to get two more two more hives. So for us, if we can catch two, that saves us $300. It puts that $300 back in our pocket essentially and puts us back where we were. So I'm gonna run around, do a couple things quick, and get back with you guys in a minute.
They're landing on me.
Okay,
yeah, I'm not trying to be here that long. We got a board here. I'm gonna try to set this nuke on. I'm putting the nuke in closer, and then I'm gonna lift it below there. Some of them are landing on me. Nothing yet. Oh, that's crazy to see.
We did bring your clothes and your hood.
Started falling. I need another stick.
Right there. Okay. Yeah.
Okay, give me the camera for a minute.
Okay.
Thank you, my lady.
So the swarm gathers while they wait for an opportunity to go to a new hive. They've normally got scouts, so some of these are heading down right now. If some of the scouts head down, they'll encourage the rest to come, and then we'll hopefully get the queen in there too. At this point, to get them in, I may give them a little bump, and they're definitely more active than they were a minute ago. So at this point they're starting to go in, but that queen is the ticket. That queen's in the middle of there. So I'm gonna try to knock these off into there carefully. Okay, I'm gonna back up just a second. And hopefully they'll continue to go into there. It's just for a man in short sleeves, flip-flops, and a t-shirt. It became a little intimidating. Kids, how about a bamboo? Is there a bamboo up towards the garden?
Yes.
You can probably hear that this is a lot louder right now. So the goal is to get them to think that this is their new home. That's the goal right now. We're working on it, and I think it'll work. Very good. That's fine. Hand it over and through. So now I'm just, you know, trying to touch it from a further distance and see if I can encourage especially that queen to go in there. If they go in, that queen will be, you know, in there. If they don't want to go in, it'll be because that queen did not. There we go. Nice and chill. That's a lot of bees to be flying around me. Yeah, you do. I do not. And I'm just backing up slowly. So, cool thing here is that if we're actually able to keep the bees, then we're really beekeepers too, rather than just releasing swarms into the wild. I just want to make sure that that queen actually falls in there. Wow, and that is amazing, because you said this about the size of the last swarm too, huh?
Kind of, yeah.
You think it's a little bit bigger or a little less?
Maybe a little less.
Wow, but that many extra bees could come out of a hive. So on our end, we're new at this. We only started getting bees last year, right?
Yes, sir.
The first year we bought some and tried, started getting into it. Have a number of people who are rather experienced who are at our disposal, meaning that we, you know, we can reach out to them whenever we need for advice and stuff like that. So we've been doing a good amount of that. And of course, trying to educate ourselves too, but a lot of our learning is hands-on. That's what we're doing right now. We didn't really research catching swarms much. Somehow, Red Pepper knew enough about it that they were able to be successful. Her and Mama Pepper took care of it. This is my first time trying anything like this. I'm hoping it works, but that's as far as I've got so far. I'm hoping it works, you know. I have no guarantee. Oh, this is a good time of year too. Check this out. This thorny crazy barbed wire of the woods, greenbrier. High in protein, very tasty. I love that wild edible. That's a bonus for the video. Let's check the status here. Seems there are more bees going in, less bees flying around, at least by a little bit. And I'm gonna see if that thing starts kind of rebuilding up there, or if they kind of head more into the nuke. There's still quite a bit on the branch. I'm not sure if the queen fell off. I may try one more kind of jostle of this thing to see. Look at that. You've got a 9-year-old in a bee suit with a 6-year-old? With a 6-year-old with no bee suit helping make sure she's ready right here. And like I said, this is kind of one of the most chilled times for them. Our hives are pretty good though too. We can walk right up to them most of the time. They don't really care. So yeah, I'm gonna give that one more poke here.
Yeah, they're all still up there.
Up here?
Yeah.
That was a lot of bees that fell in. They're getting a little more curious about me, so I'm getting a little less curious about them. Hey, your zipper's open in the front of your suit.
Oh.
Yeah, they'd be stinging you in the belly, little girl. Mama, don't you teach these children how to dress themselves? So, over time, they should continue to work their way into there. Kind of a precarious situation. It's resting on a 6-foot fence picket with a couple of sticks propping up. I'm going to reinforce the sticks propping up because I do not want it to slide and tip out and the bees spill on the ground. But once they kind of settle down and get in there, we'll cap it and move it out of there. And that may be a job for you, child, since you're suited up and ready. So as a 9-year-old beekeeper just getting started, what do you think about this whole thing?
It's pretty cool.
Yeah?
Yeah, I mean, last time it was up in a tree and we had to use ladders to get it, and I was standing on the edge of the fence, but...
Yeah, how was that?
It was fun.
And it was hot then, too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, what were the scary things about that one?
Well, the bees. My gloves weren't put on all the way.
Okay.
The bees were landing on my arms.
Oh.
And I didn't want them to sting me, but no one got stung.
Okay, I'm seeing a cluster on top of here I'm kind of concerned about. I want to make sure.
Do you want me to knock it down?
Oh, well, I almost want you to come on this side, reach through the fence, and just kind of knock them in. Because there's quite a few. It seems like they're going up onto that branch still. I'm thinking the queen is still on that branch. Now, I don't want them to, you know.
I bumped.
Yeah, don't. Oh, yeah. Let me put this one back in place for you. And then just brush them into that thing real nice and gentle, because you know they're bees. They got thin exoskeletons. The queen might be somewhere in that type of area, and I don't want you to kill her if she is, you know. And don't miss the box. Hold on, push the box back with your other hand. Are you getting stung at all? What?
No, sir.
No, okay.
Okay, all the bees are in there.
Okay.
And they're not going back in there, so these bees are friendly.
Wow. He put them in his box?
Yeah.
And then be careful not to tip it.
So friendly.
And we may, at this point, we may... Can you grab the sides of that box? I'll remove the stick, and we're just gonna put it next to this fence, so the fence is gonna be the back of it. Okay, do you have it with two hands?
Yes.
I'm removing the left stick, and then I'm removing the right stick. Now I want you to lift it up and pull it towards yourself and just set it on that side of the fence. Kind of flat. There you go. Set it there where we're gonna have more room to cap it when we need to. What do you think about your face right there, child?
Aww.
So this is the second swarm you helped catch, huh?
Yes, sir.
In like the past 3 days.
Yeah. We caught the last one last Friday and it's only...
Okay, I'm going to get one more frame and we're going to stick it in there too. I'll hand it to you from this side and then you can put it in. Yeah, and they're going in the entrance of the nuke already. But you see how built up there on the sides? Mm-hmm. I'm gonna need you to get that stick off the top carefully. Don't remove any bees with the stick, just remove that stick. And I will go get one more frame. Well, that's quite a quite a pile.
They're going down into the frames and doing stuff.
And again, here's pretty much my outfit right here. And I could have got more dressed, trust me. It's just, if I can make $150, no, I don't want to say that. I don't want to say by putting on less clothes if I can make $150. Yeah, time was of the essence. We didn't want the scouts to find a good hole for them and to have them go back to the wild. Let me get another frame and maybe the cover.
I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna sneak up on this side. And then very gently. And then I think we should prop it off the fence a little bit because of how many are right there on the fence line. Mm-hmm. So get a stick maybe. And prop it off just a little bit.
It's about an inch away.
Okay, excellent. So you think we give it a little bit and then put the cap on?
We got it down and put the cap on and put it where we wanted to. But with this many bees flying around,
you think wait a little bit?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna wait a little bit. And again, I'm not telling my 9-year-old to, you know, tell me what to do. We're just taking input from others. Can learn from anyone sometimes. She's got more experience than I. She's done this once successfully. I'm hoping to do it once successfully by the time we're done. So far, I'm only in the process of doing it once. So we're gonna wait a little bit. Hopefully they die down a bit and then we're gonna cap it and go from there. Baby, don't be sad. Really?
I found 3 of them, but they're ruined a little bit.
Dude, that is a real four-leaf clover. I used to sometimes tear one in half, and then tear the other two in half, and pull half of off two, and then take the one I tore in half and spin one backwards so it looked like a four-leaf clover, but that is for real. Aw, you lucky little boy. Now don't get stung by a bee. Or it'll all wear off in about 3 seconds. Bugger? What do you think about that?
It's cool.
What do the bees do for us?
They make honey.
And what else do they do for us?
They make swarms.
No, they make swarms and they make honey, but what do they do in our garden?
They make honey.
Yeah, but where do they get the honey from? From the flowers. And when they go to the flowers, they pollinate it. So like if you want more strawberries and you have more bees that are pollinating all the flowers, that's how it's gonna work and it's gonna be good. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Child, what are you doing?
Trying to catch a bee.
Trying to catch a bee? Girl, you got a box full in front of you.
No,
hey, let them be. Yeah, we'll give them a little space for a minute and keep an eye on them. And I'm gonna check the other two. Kind of cool investment though too when, you know, one hive can all of a sudden... What in the world?
What?
He just, now he's got two.
Where are you finding?
Huh. Interesting. But when you can take a hive like this, and all of a sudden get two more from it. I'll show you that other nuke so you can know that these guys are still going in here. They're still doing all right. And we're just gonna do a quick peek. When I say put her back, put her back. They have a hive to defend. So in here, and this is just a temporary home, but you can see they're on there and they're starting to work. So that's good. As they kind of move forward, we'll move them up to a actual frame hive and go from there. But they're on there, they're good. Cover them, baby girl. And we'll do a queen check on that soon. I'll get suited up. It may not be today, but in the near future.
Yeah, I'm a suit.
You have the suit here, huh? Okay. And then over here is this one. And this one, if you look, you know, these aren't just robber bees. This is an active hive. And they're doing all right.
Do you want me to open it?
No, you don't need to open it. We're doing fine. And look at all these flowers, the wild blackberries they're here to take care of. Bell pepper. You say bee? Can you say bee? Oh, is that where they were? They were over there? Okay. Wait a minute, what?
I found 2 4-leafs. I found a 5-leaf clover.
We got mutant clovers on our land. You're right, that's a 5-leaf clover.
And I found 2 4-leaf clovers.
Wow.
And I
have 3
in his hand.
Genuine 4-leaf clovers. You guys ever found any? The most I ever found was down in a big old patch of clover down in Alabama. And I think I found 5 in one day, but one of them I lost. The other ones I pressed and kept flat. And then put around a little picture of me with my first guinea pig ever. His name was Crazy Legs. Had a nice little picture of me sitting on the stairs of my parents' house petting him. A nice little hair, nice little clothes on. Nice little Crazy Legs guinea pig. And 4 little 4-leaf clovers around him. I don't know why I put them there, but that's what I did. What do you got? He found clovers. Whoa. So this is part of what the bees help us with. You kids can grab those. You guys can each find some. And I'll take this one that's split open by your feet there, little girl. See that one? Yeah.
This one's good, bugger. We just need
Somebody was nibbling on that. But it's still got some good stuff. What do you got there? Oh, guys, those look like they'd be much better in about 2 days. That one's pretty good.
The squirrels might get them by then, Pops.
Gotta
get them while you're home.
What's your problem, girl?
I can't get it through my screen.
Bugger, how is it?
Good.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, kids, don't pick them when they're that white, little girl. Good things come to those who wait. We'll be patient.
Another 5-leaf clover. See?
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
It goes out the middle. Look at this teeny slug on mine, Pa.
Yeah, that's going to be a problem. They're what's going to cause us troubles. I may try to make a queen catcher, too. Just to locate the queen, get her in the queen catcher, and then have her in the box till the rest of the bees settle down and then let her out. I'm going to look into that quick and possibly do that. So at this point, a lot of them have moved down into the frames. I can see them down in between there pretty well. There's far less on top. A little less flying around than when we were right here. So red pepper is going to try to cap this. And then just watch that right side especially. Actually, why don't I cap it if you brush them in from the other side? Okay. So I'm going to have her go over and just kind of brush them off the edge. Because they're still on the edge. That's why we moved up the fence earlier. And then just kind of knock those in. And then I'm going to hand you this. Once you get most of them in. Okay. Here you go, girl. Nice and gentle. Nice and gentle. And I'm watching her white suit. None of them are even really trying to attack her at this point. There's a few flying around, a few that are curious. Is that all the way on?
Yeah.
It looks crooked in the front, significantly. Do you see that? See if you can fix that a little bit. So now they should start using the entrance. You should just be able to tip it up a little bit and push down on this front corner. There you go. That's it. That's what I'm looking for. And then maybe slide it back just a tiny bit for right now. Oh, that sticks right behind there. Okay.
I need something to pop it up.
Yeah. I don't know if I have a short stick. Maybe put across that level right here. No, pull it across the level of the chain link fence, the cattle panel. Yeah, right across there. There you go. And then set it down. Good girl. That looks awesome. A lot of them are going in there. So I'm hoping that queen is in there. I'm going to check with one of my bee guys for a minute and see what he thinks. But yeah, they're pouring in that hole. That is awesome.
Now there's only a few of them.
I'll give you guys once you put that cap on, they just began pouring in at the bottom of the hole. No. I don't see one with a long enough abdomen.
All the middle ones. Oh.
Child. She's running into issues. So I was going to show you this kale. Because how is that kale? Kale, and it made it through the winter. Now it's going to flower, which means it'll go to seed. We've been picking it. We've been cutting it. We just had some kale and eggs the other day. Like yesterday. And the day before. But look at these leaves. A little bit goes a long way. So, happy to see them doing so well. And then soon we'll have, oh, look at that. Honeybee on there. Yeah, there's one here. There's one right back there. Yeah, the honeybees know what's up. See that bugger? So when this kale grows, bugger,
mm-hmm.
and it goes to flower,
yeah.
then the bees come and they pollinate it. Do you see the honeybees running around those flowers?
Mm-hmm. That's that one.
Oh, and he's picking some of the, here's one. He's picking these little harlequin beetles off here to take to the pond.
Mm-hmm.
And who takes care of them at the pond?
The fish.
So he throws them in the pond and the fish that are in there, here's two bug.
Thank you.
You're welcome. He throws them in the pond and then the fish eat them. You want to show me quick?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. I think a while ago I did a video talking about like four byproducts I have in a pond that I hadn't originally thought of when I got the pond, when I put it in, but living it out and watching these kids, they're like, oh wow, look at all these benefits that I didn't even think of when I put it in. So at the moment, I've got to cut back on the green, but he just tossed one in. Red, step back because you're so white. Don't want it to be big and scary for him. So let's see if anything's in here that's hungry enough for him right now. They're wiggling good.
If you put a worm in there and you hang on to it, the fish will come and bite it.
Yeah, they'll rip the worm right out of your hand, won't they?
Yeah, sometimes you can jerk one up on a fishbowl with little worms on there. Ooh.
They're not getting them yet, but he was just feeding them and they were hitting them. Bugger, stay out of the bushes there. You never know where there's going to be a snake or something. Your job is to stay on the sand around the pond. Well, there is fish in there anyway.
Yeah.
They'll eat them later, I guess. All right, back to the bees. So tell me a little bit, how did you guys do this catch? Which branch were they in? This one right here, yeah.
So I found them in the tree. I thought they were a swarm of flies because of our carcasses in their pen. And Sweet Pepper was in the chicken pen. So then I told her that there was something buzzing around in the trees and I was going to go tell Mama and the rest of the kids. And then we ran outside and saw it was actually a bee. So later that day we took care of it. And we had to bring both the ladders. It was kind of funny.
So you climbed the ladders and you got a nuke. What all went down?
In the nuke?
Well, I mean, you guys had to, did you hold the nuke underneath there? Did you smack the tree and let them fall? What happened?
We held the nuke under there at first, and bees started going in there. And then Mom Pepper kind of shook the branch a teeny bit and had Monster Truck get the kitchen broom.
Oh, to brush them off?
Yeah, and we brushed them off.
I guess that's got a long handle.
And then it was the one with no handle.
Oh, okay.
So it was
okay.
Easy to eat.
Oh, sure. Because she was on the ladder.
Yeah. And then we got them in the box and I capped them and ran and got the two other frames. And then Mom Pepper didn't know where to put them, so Monster Truck ran and got a brick and then we set them on top of the brick.
Wow. Great job, by the way.
And we looked in the other hives. Because Mom Pepper wanted to see if the queen was in there.
Right, right.
But they were too, the smoke didn't really help them, I guess.
Okay.
Kind of made them more mad.
Oh. So, the way I understand it after talking to one of my bee guys, is it's not uncommon for a hive to split in the spring. But to have two of them happen seems kind of, like this thing would have to be packed full is what he was saying. I don't believe that's the case, but we're gonna go in here and check, just see how this particular hive is doing. It's possible that I could have caught a wild one, but again, when the hive is where I'm standing, and one was caught there, and the other one was caught right there, to me it seems like this could very easily be the source. So we're gonna go in here, we're gonna take a peek, see what's going on, and see if we can learn anything
as we do it. So on this one, this top frame was really only put here to kind of keep it safe because I didn't have a good place to store it. This hive actually exists below here. And in this section, there's a good cluster of them in the middle that are starting to work on stuff. So you can see them on there. They're doing stuff. They're hard at work. But it's really only the couple center of these that's actually got the bees in on this layer. And then down below that, we have a pretty full hive, as you can see. A lot of bees there. If I lift one of these, you're gonna see a lot of activity, a lot of stuff going on. So with as many as are here, I don't know if both of those swarms came out of here or not. I'm not really a bee guy. I'm just learning how to be. So I put this back together, but they still got room for growth for sure. And this 10 frame here will be able to be used as I get one of these other ones out of a nuke eventually as they continue on. That's good girl. So Pinky Pepper is helping me right now, and we're looking at this first swarm that they caught. Right now, this is empty and this is empty, and this is empty and this is empty, and this side of this one is empty. The middle's full, and then we have another empty. So Pinky, would you show me how many they caught? Start at one of them and we'll just look. So I mean, this is that first swarm they caught, and they're hard at work building there, if you can see that. There's a lot of bees there. I'll show you from the backside quick. Same thing, looking good. You can, did that thing slide in? Mm-hmm. Did the other one slide in? Oh no, maybe mm-hmm. not. I thought this one slid over to where you couldn't get it anymore. So I'm holding it back so you can put it in. So that's a good swarm in my opinion. Looks really good. And I'm on that. There you go. And then...
the next one?
And then lift up the one by you. No. The one by you. There you go. And then same thing there. Another... go a little softer and gentler. But they're building on it. And they're working. So this seems like a good swarm to me. And same thing, I showed you the other side of the other one. But yeah, pretty much the far side of this one, the middle one, looks about the same as that. So you can lower that back down, daughter. And that's the one Red Pepper and Mama caught. So Pinky's going to close that up and we're going to keep it covered in case it rains, but looks like it's doing great so far. Yeah, switch it so that's the back side. And have the other side be the front. There you go. All right. That looked good, didn't it?
Yeah, there were a lot of bees in there.
So, this is about as settled down as I think it's gonna get. And I may kind of slowly start moving it from this area. I want them to still be able to find it, so I don't want to move it far. Again, the cluster just started like right up here, the swarm. Now they're here. Pinky, do you want to pull this out and just set it over here for right now? Think you can do that? Whoa, that was a big lizard. There's some big five-line skinks that live in this brush pile. So just grab it, gently slide it towards you, and then we're just going to set it over here at the base of this tree for now. And I got a good idea of where I'm going to put it eventually. As I let it grow. Put one hand on each side maybe and just pull. Thank you, daughter. I know a lot of adults would probably be intimidated by this too, but it's cool to at least grow up with an awareness of some of this stuff, so that way if you ever need that skill later on, you got it. So spin it around, and we're gonna set it right there for right now. Okay, now we're gonna take a peek. So watch that stick on top, and then lift the lid. We'll see how we're doing here. Boy, it gets louder. Oh man. Looks like that queen must be in there or they wouldn't be staying. So watch the edge when you put that back on, and we're just gonna put it back on and leave them alone for right now. Ready? I'm gonna go like this and then you put it on. Go. Nice and gentle. Here, guys. Go back in your home. All right. Well, I think that's gonna be it for this one. Maybe I need a little bit of Mama Pepper talking about how that situation went down. For those of you guys who are still with me, that'll be your reward, your blessing for checking out the whole thing. I'm gonna let Mama Pepper tell a bit of her story because it's worth hearing. And it was just gonna be a story of Red Pepper telling her portion of it and Mama Pepper telling her portion of it and then showing you that we got this swarm, but we had the opportunity to actually catch a whole nother swarm. So how cool is that? That is awesome. That is so awesome. So, tell the people about what it was like to see a swarm in the first place, and second of all, to be able to get up on there on some ladders and take care of business. What was that like?
It was really exciting. It was really cool. Being protected with a suit, it just made it feel more comfortable, and I don't know. Sweet Pepper and I were up there, and Red Pepper and I were up there, and we weren't scared, and we were just doing it, and we were working together, and I had the other kids, you know, kind of, some of them were around helping down below with anything that they could help with, and
Pinky, you know, Pepper was watching the little ones.
And I had Monster Truck, he tried to start the smoker for me down below so I could, you know, smoke the bees a little bit, because it was my first time catching a swarm and I didn't know how they were going to behave. And I thought, you know, I didn't know if I was going to cut the branch off of Pa's fruit tree or not. And I'm like, what do? I have no clue what to do. You know, I've watched some videos, read a few things before I went out there, read a few things about catching the swarm, but when you're actually out there doing it, it's like, okay, what am I gonna do? So I texted Papa, you know, we got a swarm on the fruit tree, help, what do I do? What do you want me to do? Do you want me to cut the branch off? So it was pretty exciting though. It was really cool to be able to do that with her, with Red Pepper, and the whole experience was just awesome. And like I said, we didn't exactly, you know what we were doing, but kind of have a little bit of a, you know, idea. Red Pepper seemed to know, you know, that we had some extra nook, or nuke, she said, I said it wrong, in our garden shed. So she ran up and she got it. I'm like, if you know where that is, you know, go get it. She went and she got it, and I kind of took the box up and put it underneath the swarm up high in the tree as I climbed up the ladder and just held it there for a moment and kind of wanted them to like go in on their own and not push them in. And then after a few minutes, we took a brush from a broom and just kind of tried to gently, you know, brush them, the rest of them, into the box. And so Red Pepper held it onto the box from one side, and I held onto it from the other side, and then she brushed some in very gently too. And then at the end, we kind of tapped the branch to get any of the rust off that didn't come off. And we brought it down low, and we put the lid on it. We had some trays already in there so they could feel at home and just go in there. And yeah, we got it in there, and we were pretty amazed that we had actually done it. And Pop called back. He had a neighbor come and check on us because my battery died on my phone, so he couldn't call me back. But everything seemed to go really well. We had some bees kind of coming around and trying to sting on our net and things like that, but I think anyway. But you know, there was times where we could hear them get like really noisy, and then other times when they were quiet, and it was cool to observe all of that. And it was just exciting. It was so cool. You know, we didn't get hurt at all. We were trying to be as careful as possible and be safe. And It was good, and I was so glad that we could share that experience together, just me and my daughter. And you know, I had to call my mom up the other day and let her know, hey mom, I got a swarm, because it was really cool.
So you realize swarm that bees. We want bees, and if you can get them for free and catch a swarm, that, you know, this is kind of what had to be done at that time. So you just figured you'd rise to the occasion, figure it out, and do it, huh?
Yeah, I didn't want them to get away, and so that's what we did. We took care of business while Papa was out as safely as we could, and everything turned out really well, so.
Do you realize how much you saved our family that day? Do you know the dollar amount? By
hundreds,
catching that swarm?
Hundreds of dollars? $150
bucks. Yeah. And then how about
savings.
Today?
And today, Sweet Pepper saw another swarm, and Papa came to the rescue for that one. So Papa and Red Pepper helped with that again. She seems to be really comfortable with the bees, and I had to kind of tell her to slow down a little bit on her movements, because you could hear the bees sometimes, like, you could hear them get louder, and I'm like, okay, you got to slow down on your movement, because you're getting a little bit fast there, and I think you might be scaring them a little bit. So, but she was really comfortable with them, so I had to remind her to slow down a little bit, but otherwise it was good.
And, you know, Pinky Pepper and I went and checked out the other nuke that you guys put the ones in from the first one on Friday. And they're doing really well. They're building stuff up. You'll have to look in there soon yourself. Just really cool to see. And just what a marvelous time. What a great learning experience. And here I am at 40. She's in her 30s. We're just learning this. But when our children, who are 11 and under, can learn it at the same time, like, what a blessing for them to at least grow up with a frame of reference. And I know people who, you know, travel around with those cardboard nukes in their vehicle just because you can see a swarm. I know one guy we were talking to who's, you know, seen multiple ones crossing the highway before. And we're definitely going to look at things in a new way that we really never have before. Because now we have that insight and that understanding, right?
Exactly.
And there's a reason people offer free swarm removal. They know there's good money in it and getting the honeybees and stuff like that. So
thank you guys once again for watching, and we'll see you again soon.
Papa out.